Hello everyone, myself Dr. Ravi Grady, and you guys are listening to me on Puvanchalay's online platform. As you know, this venture is for both online and face-to-face classes. If you guys are interested, so you can contact on the given number. Especially this institution has opened from last 3 years, is working. And in Gorakhpur, if you are in nearby areas, so you have no need to go for metropolitan cities, which are very expendable. So you can be there, and all the Delhi-based faculties are in Gorakhpur for your face-to-face classes. So as many people have joined this online classes, so this is the lecture number 26 for space technology. So here in the space technology, you should have some ideas about in this basic terminology. Those I have seen guys, mostly student confused with these terms. And here in this terminology, some questions, even UPSC prelims and mains question will also be my part of discussion. So let us start guys, space technology with some basic terminology. This is lecture number 26. Space technology. Okay, what about terms which are important? The one term is called as a satellite. Second term is shuttle. Third term is spacecraft. Fourth one is launch vehicle. Next is rocket. And one more term is missile. So these six terms are important. Even here, some of the application that you can see here right now, that is for constructive uses. And some other applications, those you can see here, it is for destructive users. Okay, everything slowly and gradually I will explain you. First, you start with a spacecraft. Okay, first you start with a spacecraft. Okay, this is a basic of this chapter, which is very, very important. Later on in the next video, I will go for the, you know, advanced level of discussion, which is a real need of UPSC examinations. But to understand that advanced level of space technology, these knowledge are very, very important. Even here in this all entire discussion today classes, guys, 3-4 objective question and subjective question of your paper, your mains paper, you will also get it. Okay, fine. How to describe a spacecraft? You start from this. All those object we send in space. Again, I repeat, all those object we send in space, all are called as a spacecraft. In a simple basic term, all those object we send in space are called spacecraft. Okay, so a spacecraft, object send in space, object send in space. So in that way, you know, spacecraft is defined. Now question is, what will come in this example of a spacecraft, those we send in the space? So here you see, you can see guys, one example is satellite and second example is shuttle. So satellite and shuttle, these are the example of a spacecraft. Okay, so spacecraft, all object we send in space is called a spacecraft. One satellite we send in the space, second shuttle we send in the space. So both will come under the example of spacecraft. Both will come under the example of spacecraft. Now listen guys, what is the space? What is space? Actually, officially space is called 100 kilometer beyond from the Earth surface. From the Earth surface, 100 kilometer and beyond this, that is the space. Officially, it is called, this is one of the line officially described. Okay, so space officially is what? 100 kilometer, beyond 100 kilometer. So 100 kilometer and beyond its distance from the Earth surface, this is called the space officially, you remember. Okay, fine. Now, one is satellite. So here question is, what about satellites? And second side, I will go into the discussion of what is shuttle. So on the second side, I will go into the discussion of shuttle. So spacecraft and shuttle, fine. Oh, sorry, satellites and shuttle. See guys, satellite, I'm talking to you about artificial satellite. I'm talking to you about artificial satellite because science and technology is a totally, technology is what? Human made. Okay, as you people know very well, moon is a natural satellite of the earth. But those satellite here, my part of discussion is the artificial satellite. You don't be confused. Okay, guys, fine. So how to describe satellite? Satellite always describe in the respect of orbit. Satellite always describe in the respect of orbit. Now question is, what is orbit? Orbit means, guys, attraction. Orbit means attraction. Okay, slowly, gradually, you will understand everything, guys. Even in the next video, I will describe orbit in more detail. Different types of orbit, where we will put the many satellites for different applications. Okay, so where we put the satellites, we send the satellite into orbits. Orbit means attraction. If I ask you guys in the respect of Earth, okay, what is the attraction? So everybody know gravity. In the respect of Earth, what is the attraction? Attraction means gravity. So satellite, whatever we people send into the orbit, it will go in the respect of gravity. One thing, guys, orbit are of two types. Orbits are of two types. Okay, what are these two types of orbit? Okay, what are these two types of orbit? See here, the one orbit that is called inner orbit. The one orbit, this is called inner orbit. And second orbit, this is called outer orbit. So there are two types of orbit. The one is inner orbit and second is the outer orbit. How to describe inner orbit? In the respect of Earth, if we people send any satellites within the attraction of Earth, it means up to Earth gravity. Okay, if any satellite will go, this is called inner orbit. And what will be inner orbit? Even guys, up to 36,000 kilometer approx. Up to approx 36,000 kilometer distance, if we put any satellite, so this satellite is under inner orbit. And what is the concept of outer orbit? Outer orbit means if satellite distance will be more than 36,000 kilometer. It means, guys, inner orbits up to that distance where Earth attraction present. From the Earth's surface up to 36,000 kilometer distance have a Earth attraction. This is called inner orbit. And beyond that distance, this is called outer orbit. Even if I ask you example, Chandrayaan, Mangalyaan. Chandrayaan and Mangalyaan are more than 36,000 kilometer. So these satellites will launch under the outer orbit. Okay, but in the respect of remote sensing satellite, in the respect of a geostationary satellite, those work for the Earth, guys. Earth based for certain countries, guys. These all the satellite will launch into the inner orbit under the attraction of Earth. So that will focus Earth and work for the Earth, guys. So I hope very well, guys, everybody clear inner orbit and outer orbit. So satellites always discuss in the respect of orbit. So either satellite will go in inner orbit or satellite will go in the outer orbit. Inner orbit under the attraction of Earth up to around 36,000 kilometer approximately. Outer orbit across 36,000 kilometer. Example, Chandrayaan, Mangalyaan type of mission will come under the example of outer orbit. Okay, everyone, fine. One thing more, guys. Those satellite we people launched, satellite never reusable. Satellite never reusable. Even I can give you an example. The first satellite those India launched with the help of Russia, it was Aryabhatta. After completion of its lifespan, still Aryabhatta is there. Aryabhatta never come back for the further uses. Even many satellite, guys, many satellites those launched in the history, guys, every satellite after completion of its lifespan, they are in their own orbits. Not functional, but they are still in their own orbit where it was launched and put successfully for their own functions. Okay, so satellites never reusable. Satellite never come back. This is the another concept you remember. Next point. If satellite never reusable, they never come back. It means astronauts or cosmonauts never go through satellites. It means life support systems are not with the satellites. That you can understand very well, guys. If it will never usable, so why you will send astronauts or cosmonauts through satellites? Life support system is not there. So in that way, satellite described. This is the simplest way to understand satellites. But second side, if you see shuttle. Satellites and shuttles, both are the example of a spacecraft, but both have different means, different purposes. Shuttle is specially used for a space delivery system. Shuttle is specially used for a space delivery system. It is used for a space delivery system. So shuttle is used for a space delivery system. Okay, one thing more, guys. If space delivery system means, if suppose I want to deliver something in the space, either it's astronauts or cosmonauts. Either it's astronauts or cosmonaut. You know, guys, what about the difference between astronaut and cosmonaut? Even astronaut and the cosmonaut both are same. Russian use for astronaut as a cosmonaut terms. Neither worldwide everybody use astronauts. So either you call astronauts and the cosmonaut both are same. But Russian term for any astronaut is the cosmonaut. But India, US, every countries, they are using astronauts. So both are same. Space delivery system means if you want to send the astronauts and the cosmonaut in the space, the shuttle will be useful. Even if you have a plan for Gaganyaan mission, where you have a plan to send 3 astronauts in the space, so of course they will go through shuttle. Because shuttle have a life support system. Shuttle have a life support system. Shuttle is reusable. Shuttle is reusable. The shuttle we can use further, guys. Is a life support system. Shuttle we can use again as a reusable. In that way, guys, shuttle is defined. In that way, shuttle is defined. Under one, guys. So shuttle have a life support system. Shuttle can be further used even for the development of International Space Station. If you want to develop International Space Station, if you want to develop International Space Station, you know, this is developed with the help of shuttle. International Space Station set up with the help of shuttle. International Space Station is an experimental place. Okay, it is an experimental place which is developed by the help of many countries. Because International Space Station have a need of higher technology, have a lot of expenditure. So many countries even work together. India was not the participatory of International Space Station. But those International Space Station installed and developed in the low Earth orbit at distance of 400-500 kilometer, it set up with the help of shuttle. Shuttle carried a small part of the International Space Station and installed at that particular place. Even International Space Station that launched many years back, developed for experimental purposes. What about the function of International Space Station? I will discuss with you guys in the coming discussion. International Space Station was UPSC question in 2007-8 mains paper. Okay, and one question that UPSC has in 2019 mains paper, India's space station, that India made a target for 2030. But before it, India has a plan for Gaganyaan, India has a plan for Venus mission, India has a plan for Aditya mission. So that all future mission I will discuss with you. And India's space station that India has planned after successful of Gaganyaan. Somehow I got with the ISRO notification that by 2030, India has planned to develop own space station. Okay, so that will come in the next part. But you tell me, you people clear the function of shuttle. So shuttle we can use for space delivery system. Astronauts, cosmonauts you want to send, so shuttle will be used. If you want to set up International Space Station, a very huge size of body, you want to carry modules, then come back, the next module carry, then come back, the next module carry. So of course here shuttle will be useful. Okay, in that way, guys, shuttle is important. Okay, in that way, shuttle is important. Fine. Even with shuttle, some more connections, and that connection is called EVA. That is called EVA, or you can call as a spacewalk. Either EVA or you can call as a spacewalk. What is EVA? EVA is an extravehicular activity. EVA is an extravehicular activity. EVA is an extravehicular activity. Extravehicular activity, it was a mains question paper in 2008 around. If you go and check, guys, UPSC asked this question in your mains paper. Nearby the same year, International Space Station was also in your mains paper. If by mistake, you will see question paper, guys. What about the discussion I am doing? Here, many questions UPSC made in your prelims and mains paper. Extravehicular activity. What is this concept, guys? Across the shuttle, astronauts will go outside for their own experiment purposes. This is called spacewalk or extravehicular activity. Across the vehicle, guys, astronauts are going. Okay, and they are doing their own experiment work and all. Okay, even they can carry some sample of some planets, yeah, satellites somewhere in the space, guys. So extravehicular activities are using. Even extravehicular activities, I mentioned this entire topic mentioned in my book also, okay, because it is a UPSC mains paper, question paper, prelims examination. So this is the demand, okay, fine. There are two types of EBA. See guys, even some movies are very important to see everyone. Even three movies I will advise to understand concept of many concept of space technology. The one I will advise for Gravity. Second, I will advise Interstellar. And one more movie that you should see, guys. Okay, that is Parmadu, where the concept of the blind spot and the satellite is coming in front of a particular region, and then the next satellite is coming. So in between, have certain gap. Okay, in Parmad movie, you can understand this blind spot. And this entire discussion will be in my further lecture, guys. Okay. Yeah, I was talking to you about extravehicular activity. Extravehicular activity means a kind of a spacewalk. Extravehicular activity means a kind of spacewalk. See, there are two types. The one that is called tethered. The one that is called tethered. Even whenever it was in your mains paper around 2008. So you have to write about tethered or untethered. Two types of EVA. The one is tethered and second is untethered EVA. So one is tethered and second is a untethered EVA. How to describe tethered and untethered? Very simple, guys. Suppose this is a shuttle. Suppose this is a shuttle. This is the shuttle. Okay. If through shuttle, astronauts are connected through some tube-like structure, a kind of supporting system, and that supporting system connect astronauts to the shuttle. It is very similar to, guys, that a fetus is connecting through shuttle with the help of umbilical cord, a placenta, whatever you can call umbilical cord. Okay, so and through umbilical cord from the mother body, this fetus is getting everything, oxygen, nutrition, food, support, everything, guys. Okay, and this fetus even safe. Similarly, from the shuttle body, astronauts is connecting. Okay, astronauts is connected here with this some tube like structure, and now all the life support system for the astronaut is coming here. Up to certain distance where the tube have a length, this astronauts will go and walk their own, do their own activities. This is what tether type EVA. Here the body is connected through this tube like structure. But what about untethered? Here in the case of untethered, body is independent. Bodies independent are free from shuttle, guys. Bodies independent are free from shuttle. And astronauts will be moved out from the shuttle, and walk, and they will do their own activities. If you will see in Gravity movie, guys, in the Gravity movie, those astronauts was in the space. They have a small vehicles in the space, and through the help of that vehicle, they were moving. Even they have oxygen as a support system backside. In that way, they were working there, guys. They involved totally. So that is what? That is untethered EVA. So untethered EVA, here body is independent and free from shuttle. Okay, in Gravity movie, it will be very, very clear. That's why I told you guys, you have to see Gravity movie, which is very, very important for understanding this entire concept. Okay, okay. So, satellites, shuttle, as a general spacecraft, everybody clear. Okay, even I can tell you guys, this Chandrayaan and Mangalyaan are also kind of satellites. Yeah, simply you can call it a spacecraft that's sent in the space for the study of Moon and Mars. Okay, fine. Now come some other parts like launch vehicle, rocket and missiles. See guys. So other concepts like launch vehicle, rocket and missiles. How to describe rockets? Rocket is a kind of, in a very simple manner I can tell you, it is a kind of motor or engine. Okay, as a very layman term, I'm describing you. Okay, and try to understand in layman concepts. Rocket is a kind of motor or engine. Okay, in that way, I'm just telling you. And this motor or engine, we people do this testing. Even in UPSC mains have a question, spot 6 rocket. It was a mains question paper in 2012. You go and check, guys. By mistake, if you will see this question, you will get it. UPSC asked this question in 2012 mains. Even in my every lecture, guys, those I make here, guys, in this platform. Yeah, anywhere, guys, whenever I discuss in the classroom. Okay, I always introduce the question paper. So this is the question from this, regarding this, in which year. So it even help you a lot, guys, to understand demand of UPSC. in even in the state PCS guys. Okay. So rocket in layman term, I can tell you is a kind of motor engine technology. Those people do testing. Not we, even everybody is doing this testing. Okay, and see rocket, we install into a launch vehicles and even in the missiles. So missiles and launch vehicles, they also equipped with the rocket based motor and engine technology. They have propellants. If you install this technology into launch vehicle, so launch vehicle will use for constructive purposes. Through the help of launch vehicle, we send spacecraft. It means we send the satellites and shuttle. Okay. So that those Gaganyaan, you have a planning to send it, guys. Inside the Gaganyaan, okay, Gaganyaan will what? It is a kind of shuttle type of technology. Okay, that will send with the help of launch vehicle. And here India will use GSLV MK3. That discussion under the part of launch vehicle. Not here, this is the introductory parts only. Introduction of all the topics. In the detailed discussion of launch vehicle, I will tell you GSLV MK3 is very important, which can carry 4,000 kilogram warhead in the GTO orbit and 8,000 to 10,000 in the low Earth orbit. And Gaganyaan, we have a planning to send in the low Earth orbit. Okay, and those will make successful easily by the help of GSLV MK3. Okay, everyone? Fine. So this is a in that way rockets define rocket. If you install into the launch vehicle, so it will be utilized to send a spacecraft. And if you install into the missile, so missile will be utilized for to send what? Warhead. Warhead means destructive purposes. Warhead means destructive purposes. Warhead of two types that in the defense technology I will discuss with you. The one type of warhead is called as a conventional warhead. Normal warhead. Conventional warhead, and second type of warhead is called nuke. Nuke means nuclear warhead. Nuclear warhead means here you can carry atom bomb. Here you can carry atom bomb. So in that way, warhead decided. Okay, different types of warheads, arsenals, wagera. So warhead two types. One is a conventional, and second is a nuclear warhead. Nuclear warhead have a atom bomb. Uranium thorium type of fuel, plutonium type of fuel. We are using here. In that way, guys, all the entire basic terms defined. One thing more, those satellites, not India, every country's launch in the space. We put into the orbits. What happened after completion of its lifespan? You know, this every satellites have some lifespan, 2 years, 6 years, 5 years, 10 years, 15 years. What will come after this completion of lifespan? Anyone? You know what happened of these satellites? Nothing, guys. After completion of this, all the satellites in the orbits, satellite never come back. It means from Aryabhat to till now, I'm not telling for India only, for every countries, guys. All those countries launch the satellites after completion of its lifespan, still satellites are there. Satellites never back. It means with time, these are increasing as a space debris. Those are popular as a space junk. Those are called as a space junk. So with time in the space, these debris are going to increase as a space junk. You know, this space junk are also popular. I mentioned this one in my book as a Kessler syndrome. And Kessler syndrome was UPSC question. But this was in your mains paper, year nearby 7, 8, 9 mains paper. UPSC has Kessler syndrome. Even for the state pieces, still Kessler syndrome is very important. Kessler syndrome is related to actually syndrome time of term used for many diseases. Klinefelter syndromes, Edwards, Patau's, different types of trisomic, nullisomic. This type of terms come in the syndromes, diseases type of chapter. Okay. Where? But Kessler syndrome is not disease. Kessler was a person who firstly described about the presence of a future problems as a space debris. Those are called as a space junk. Okay. Described by Kessler. So these space junks got popular with the name of Kessler syndrome. So Kessler was a person who firstly introduced about the presence and increased the number of space junk in the space. Okay, everybody. So Kessler syndrome is related to space junk, and these numbers are increasing day by day. I'm very sure you can understand. These numbers are increasing day by day. Okay, guys, fine. See, Next part. So at least 3-4 mains question paper you have seen and 2-3 objective paper you have seen. From basic terminology it came. Okay. You know, what about the main problem in civil services preparation? Those I have seen, guys. Without understanding basic concepts, you will jump and start to read the advanced topics and you have a difficulties to understand everything. Okay, so this is the reason. From basics you have to you have a knowledge, later on you go advanced level. Now one thing, guys, a very different topic which is very, very important. Here still UPSC made a question in prelims paper, even state pieces also ask questions. Topic is orbit. Topic is concept of orbit. Orbit. How orbit define or discuss? There are two parameters. Those I made specially and mentioned in book. Orbits on the basis of two parameters you rated. That will be enough for civil services examination. The one, study of orbit on the basis of distance. Study of orbit on the basis of distance. Second, study of orbit on the basis of position. So these are two parameters you follow. So study of orbit on the basis of distance and study of orbit on the basis of position. What will come? Study of orbit on the basis of distance. Okay, see guys, the one that is called LEO. What is the meaning of LEO? LEO means low earth orbit. LEO means low earth orbit. Second, that is called MEO. Second is called as MEO. MEO means medium earth orbit. This is medium earth orbit. Third concept is GEO. GEO means geostationary, better geosynchronous you can also use. Okay, so I used, okay, geosynchronous. Geosynchronous earth orbit. And the next one is HEO. HEO is what? That is high earth orbit. Here is what? This is high earth orbit. In that way, guys, distance based orbit is defined. Again, I tell you, low earth orbit, medium earth orbit, geosynchronous earth orbit and high earth orbit. Here somehow geostationary also mentioned there. Okay, geostationary, and it will be very clear, guys, that somehow in this geosynchronous and geostationary have similarity and other side you will see have a differences. And that will in next video, guys, whenever I'll go and discussion about the detail of different orbits. Okay, fine. So in that way, guys, distance wise orbit defined. Now come position wise orbit. What about position wise orbit as a polar orbit, position wise orbit as a inclined or transitional orbit, inclined or transitional orbit, and position wise as a equatorial orbit. This is the equatorial orbit. So this is the study of orbit on the basis of position. Again, I repeat, position wise polar orbit. I mentioned orbit, guys. Okay, polar orbit, inclined or transitional orbit, equatorial orbit. And this is what? Equatorial orbit. In that way, position wise orbit defined, and here distance wise orbit defined. See guys, what about the meaning of distance wise and position wise? Try to understand here. Suppose this is one of the satellite. This battery, you just imagine this is a satellite. What is this? This is a globe, earth, everybody know. You tell me, do you know about position? Of course, everybody know positions. These are pole, north pole, south pole. This is what? This is the equator. Everybody know. What is this? Equator. Okay, see. If this satellite, this is a satellite. If satellite will move pole to pole, pole to pole, pole to pole. This is what? Polar orbit. Position wise. What is the polar orbit? If direction of movement of satellites in this pole to pole direction, in this position, then it will call as a polar orbit. What is equatorial? Equatorial orbit means lie in the plane of equator in this way, then it will call as a equatorial satellite. And what about the meaning of inclined or transitional? What about the meaning of inclined or transitional orbit? Very simple, guys. Inclined or transitional means in this way, guys. In this way. In between polar and equatorial. In between any angles are there. So it is what? Even similar to here, guys. And this dimension. In this direction. So this is called inclined or transitional. So in that way, guys, position wise, orbits define polar orbit, inclined or transitional orbit, and equatorial orbit. Again, tell me, polar, equatorial, inclined or transitional. Okay, fine. Now come. Actually, low Earth orbit, this distance from the Earth's surface, around 50 to 2000 kilometer. Even somewhere you will get as a within LEO have a NEO, near Earth orbit. Okay, but you remember, guys, officially LEO, MEO, GEO, HEO, don't go on NEO. NEO means near Earth orbit. Within LEO, which will be very closest from the Earth surface, that will call as a NEO. You remember only LEO is fine. Okay, the standard book LEO is mentioned. Okay, NEO is mentioned somebody to define you that they have a very good knowledge and all, but don't be confused with that. You follow LEO, MEO, GEO and HEO, which is enough. Okay, 50 to 2000 kilometer from the Earth surface, this is generally LEO. Okay, medium Earth orbit, here the satellite will go from 5000 to 12000, but in one case it is the 20000 also. I will explain you the specific case of 20000 in the case of global positioning system, global GPS. But especially medium Earth orbit, 5000 to 12000. But because of GPS orbit, it's around 20000 kilometer. I said okay, it is inclined or transitional. 5000 to 20000, you can follow it. Okay, GEO is what? GEO here distance approx 36000 kilometer distance. GEO is what? Approx 36,000 kilometer distance. Okay. And what about the high Earth orbit? High Earth orbit, here distance will be more than 36,000 kilometer. Here distance more than 36,000 kilometer. So what you can see here, guys, I hope you can understand, guys, that up to 36,000 kilometer distance where Earth attraction present. Up to a 36,000 kilometer distance with the Earth attraction present, this is called inner orbit. Do you remember inner orbit? This is called inner orbit. This is called inner orbit. Okay, if you want to send a satellite, that satellite will be useful for Earth-based feature detection. Yeah, observation of Earth-based feature. Okay, just like for mobile communication, for remote sensing and all. So definitely it will be up to 36,000 kilometers from the Earth surface. Some satellite will be at 500 kilometers, some satellite at 80 kilometers, 800 kilometers, but all will be up to range of from Earth surface to up to 36,000 kilometers. That is inner orbit. But what about when you send more than 36,000 kilometers? That is outer orbit. So HEO will come under what? HEO will come under outer orbit. HEO will come under outer orbit. In that way, guys, orbit is defined. So inner orbit up to 36,000 kilometer, outer orbit more than 36,000 kilometer. And for outer orbit, which type of term use? That is called HEO. Now you go and see, guys, ISRO site. On ISRO site, if you go the listing of Chandrayaan and Mangalyaan, you know, officially it is mentioned Chandrayaan and Mangalyaan were in HEO orbit because they were across 36,000 kilometer. Okay, they were across 36,000 kilometer. The Chandrayaan was in lunar polar orbit. Mangalyaan was Martian transfer orbit. Okay, so what about the Chandrayaan was in the lunar polar orbit? It functioned under Chandrayaan 1, I will explain with you. Today, Chandrayaan 2 still become successful. Somehow have a problem into the lander and rover, that discussion I will do there, guys. But in that part, not here. Here you focus only high Earth orbit. So I hope you people very clear the Chandrayaan and Mangalyaan. Officially, why ISRO mentioned they send into the high Earth orbit? The reason they were outside from the Earth orbit. So they are in the outer orbit. And outer orbit is here. I hope now whenever you will go and see the ISRO site, you will never confuse. Okay, one thing more, guys, that connection is very important here. You see, those satellite will launch at the polar position. This polar position based satellite distance are here. This is the reason I mentioned both in front of them. So easily you can connect it. So polar orbit of satellites, what about distance at this position? Here the satellite distance from the Earth surface around 50 to 2000 kilometer. What about the MEO distance? That is here, distance is mentioned there, position is this, guys. That's why I mentioned in front of it. I hope you can understand right now. And similarly, guys, equatorial orbit, geosynchronous, geostationary, nearby equatorial. Okay, they are this geo, mostly. Okay, and this is the miscellaneous. This is the miscellaneous case. Now it is depend on the experiment or research. According that you people have a plan to launch a satellite. Just like I told you guys in the case of Chandrayaan 1. I told you in the case of Chandrayaan 1. The orbit is what? Lunar polar orbit. Orbit is what? Lunar polar orbit. In the case of Mangalyaan. You just listen, guys. In the case of Mangalyaan, that was Martian transfer orbit. Martian means Mars. Martian transfer orbit. Here, if you people have planned to do the study of any satellite like Chandrama, Moon, for a planet, Mangalyaan, Mars. So here it is depend on your demand, which type of experiment you want. Okay, here it is not a specific, specified by you people, especially your scientists, accordingly that they want to do their own experiment. But here it is must, guys. Here, anything possible. And detail of Chandrayaan 1, Chandrayaan 2, Mangalyaan, Astrosat, India Space Mission, Venus Mission, okay, Aditya Mission, that all discussion I will do. Those are the other future mission of India. But in coming series, you wait. So I hope you people very clear. You see this board, guys, I don't think so anybody have any kind of problem here. I made all the concepts very easy to you guys. Okay, but this is not the limit of civil services. You have to need more knowledge. This is the beginning of orbits and all. Okay, you have a need of more knowledge. So now come, guys, what about the other discussion? Those are required here. So I'm going to erase this entire one. See, what will come here? One question which is very, very important for your examination, that is, why satellite not fall down to the surface of Earth? Why satellite not fall down to the surface of Earth? You go and check UPSC question 2011 prelims. Very beautiful question, guys. Even when I have seen this question, brought a smile on my face that those people make this UPSC exam as a factual exam. So they will definitely suffer to tick this answer. Okay, why satellite not fall down to the surface of Earth? Okay, there are many concepts was written there, orbital speed, orbital accelerations, certain accelerations are required, speeds are required. So that discussion is important. The latter one, guys, types of orbits. Okay, don't tell types of, okay, fine, types of orbit. The next one as a types of orbit. So which type of orbit? See, guys. The one orbit you have to know that is called polar orbit. Okay. The one is the polar orbit. Second orbit you have to know, this is called polar sun synchronous orbit, the second one. Third one is GPS orbit. Third one is GPS orbit. Fourth one is geosynchronous orbit. Fifth one is geosynchronous transfer orbit. This is GTO. Next one is geostationary Earth orbit. This is GEO. Okay, so these are the main orbit which are important for exam. One more orbit that I will explain with you, but it will come with the discussion of Aditya mission, that is called Halo orbit. Okay, that make a equilibrium of gravitational forces, Coriolis, centrifugal forces, they all will be in balance. And from that place, guys, it is very easy and observe study of sun and all. Okay, around 2 million kilometer distance from the surface, and the very specific point that one of the mathematician has defined, that point Lagrange, that is the L1 point. So that discussion I will do, but not here. This discussion I will do with the Aditya mission, especially. Even still, UPSC or any state teachers never ask any question from L1 point of Halo orbit, but it is a good question for your paper. Okay. So these are the orbits. Okay, and here is a important question that UPSC will ask you. Even see, guys, what about the relation between geostationary and geosynchronous? Okay, that one of the question in UPSC 2011 again asked, what about the condition behind the geostationary orbit? 2011 prelims. Why geostationary orbit is a geostationary? Okay, that was the question. Condition behind the geostationary orbit, 2011 prelims. And see, guys, that is state PCS. I have seen from last 7-8 years what happened. Many of UPSC questions directly came under state PCS. Even I have seen many questions in UPPSC directly came from UPSC questions. So I will suggest to everyone, if you are going for state PCS, so you should solve state UPSC question paper. That will help you guys. So what about the condition behind the geostationary Earth orbit? It is a geosynchronous orbit, lie planes of the equator, distance 22,200 something kilometer. Okay, it's a circular orbit. So in that way, UPSC question was in 2011. You see, yeah, by mistake, if you will see. Okay, so you will get it, guys. Those I'm telling you how this concrete material and important and focused material for according to your examination, according to demand. Okay, and second side, guys, the one side types of orbit. Okay, see topics, and second side about satellites. Okay, second side about satellites. Those India launched into the orbit for specific functions. Five types of satellite officially those India launched. The one that is called experimental satellite. One as a experimental satellite. Okay, one as an experimental satellite like Aryabhatta, Bhaskara, Rohini, like this type of experimental satellite. The second one is India also launched university satellite. Okay, university satellite. I can give you some example that university-based satellites, university students have developed it, research level that satellite even developed. But when this ISRO launched many other satellites, so ISRO also launched the university satellites. Even I can give you example like SRMSAT, Annamalai University, ANUSAT, SRM University, Chennai, Annamalai University satellite. So in that way, guys, the University Satellite India launch. University Satellite India launch. The third one is the Earth Observation Satellite. Third one is the Earth Observation Satellite. Earth Observation Satellite. Fourth one is the remote sensing satellite. The fourth one is the remote sensing satellite. Fifth one is the INSAT. You can call as a GSAT. INSAT means the earlier Indian satellites, and geosynchronous or geostationary satellite. Earlier the name was InSight, but today we are using the name as a GSAT. Here again have some reason behind it. Earlier why InSight, now today is a GSAT. Okay, actually guys, one side you have seen many orbits. In that orbit we launched the different satellites, and every discussion are in the respect of India. Okay, every discussions are in the respect of India. Okay, see guys, experimental satellites, university satellites, earth observation satellite, remote sensing satellite, InSight and GSAT, these satellites are functional for various purposes. And why these satellites become functional for various purposes? Reason, these satellites put in different orbits. So the function of satellites become possible due to launch into the certain orbits. If we will not launch this satellite into the specific orbit, this satellite will not be meaningful to you guys. Okay, so this is the reason. Here you should be very, very clear in the beginning which type of satellite in which type of orbit we launch, and then this orbit and satellite both means same functions. I don't know what UPSC as state teachers can demand. They can tell you what is the function of polar sun synchronous orbit. Okay, they can ask you what is the function of remote sensing satellite. Do you know guys, the best remote sensing satellites are actually in polar sun synchronous orbit. In that way UPSC can confuse you, state PCS can confuse you. The problem, concept problem. So if I ask you what is the function of polar sun synchronous orbit, so similar those are the function of remote sensing satellite. In that way guys, entire discussion is required. And these all discussions, this is the advanced level of discussion right now, which is the demand of your examinations. Those UPSC and all state PCS are expecting with you. See question paper, see question paper. Okay, and those satellite India launch. Okay, so these all entire discussion I will do in next class, next video. So thank you everybody, and regarding any kind of queries regarding my module classes of Science Tech Environment, our entire GS class, our face-to-face class if you are nearby Gorakhpur regions, so you can contact on the given number. Those are display here in the lower side of this videos, you can see here guys. So take care of yourself guys, thank you so much to listen me, and give me your attentions. Even many people have already joined these classes, so you already have a WhatsApp group, so kindly update me there time to time. So thank you everybody, have a good day, bye.